Welcome once again. In this video, we will see to set up and animating a zoom view while pressing the right button of the mouse in first-person template. The field of view is a core element of modern first-person shooters. This is a variable in the form of a player's ability to look down the scope of a gun to get a closer view of a target. This is a significant contributor to the feeling of accuracy and control that modern shooters provide. Let's add a simple form of this functionality to our character. In an empty section of the grid, next to your mouse input nodes, right-click, search for an input action zoom trigger node, and add it. We want to modify the FOV value that is contained within the first-person camera component, so we go to the Components panel and drag first-person camera out onto the event graph. Drag the output pin into empty space. Search for the set field of view node and place it. Lowering the field of view gives the effect of zooming into a narrower area in the center of the screen. Since the default field of view value is set to 90 for our zoom, let's set the field of view in the set node to 45, like this. Click and drag the output execution pin from the right-click trigger node to the input execution pin of the set node. Now compile and save and click on play. You will notice that when you right-click, the FOV will snap to a narrow, zoomed-in view. Any instance where the main camera snaps from one position to another can be jarring for a player, so we will have to modify this behavior further. Here we have to use a timeline to smooth transitions. To change the FOV smoothly, we will need to create an animation that shows a gradual change in the actor over time. To do so, return to the event graph of the first-person character blueprint. Press Alt and click on the pressed output execution pin of the input action zoom node to break the connection. Drag a new wire out from pressed to empty space. Search for and select Add Timeline to add a timeline node. A timeline will allow us to change a value, such as the field of view on a camera, over a designated amount of time. There are two primary ways of accomplishing animations in Unreal Engine 5. Timelines are perfect for simple value changes, such as the rotation of a door. For more complex, character-based, or cinematic animations, you would want to look into Matinee, the engine's built-in animation system. Matinee and complex animations are out of the scope of this video. To change the value within the timeline, double-click on the timeline node. This will open up the timeline editor. You will see four buttons in the top left corner of the editor. Each of these will add a different kind of value to be changed over the course of the timeline. Because FOV is represented by a numerical value, we will want to click on the button with the F label, Add Float Track. Doing so will add a timeline and prompt you to label the value to be changed. Let's label this as Field of View. We will now have to edit the values over different time intervals, as shown here. To accomplish this, hold down Shift, and click close to the 0, 0 point on the graph. You will see the time and value fields appear in the top left part of the graph. This allows precision tuning of our timeline. Ensure that the time is set to exactly 0.0 and set the value to 90, our default FOV. We want the zoom animation to be quick, so at the top of the timeline editor, find the field next to length, and change the value to 0.3 to limit the range of the animation to 0.3 seconds. Now press Shift and click at the end of the white area of the graph. Fine-tune the fields to 0.3 for time and 45 for value. Note that whole numbers entered in the value field will automatically be translated into floating point values that are nearly identical, as seen here. The difference is not large enough to produce any observable effect, so we don't have to concern ourselves with this translation. Line reflecting the value gradually slopes down from 90 degrees to 45 degrees. This means that, when this animation is called, the player's FOV will smoothly transition from being zoomed out to zoomed in, rather than a jarring switch between the two values. This is the advantage of using timelines over changing the values directly with a set value blueprint. Now return to the event graph. We will want to connect our timeline into our set FOV operation, just like what is shown here. Drag the new field of view output pin into the field of view field in the set node overriding your value of 45. Now link the update output execution pin from the timeline to the set node. This sets up the functions such that every time the FOV value is updated, it passes the new value to the set function. Because of our timeline setup, many values between 90 and 45 will be passed to set, enabling a gradual transition between the two extremes over 0.3 seconds. Finally, we want the zooming to end when the right mouse button is released. To do this, drag the released pin from the input action zoom node to the reverse pin of the timeline node. This will cause the timeline animation to play in reverse order when the button is released, ensuring that we have a smooth transition back to our normal camera view. Also, remember to apply a comment to the node group so that you remember what this functionality does if you revisit it later. Hope from this video, you will start to move into building in more advanced mechanics in an easy-to-follow step-by-step approach, which will allow you to play around and build your own content to eventually build your own game. Thanks a lot. See you in the next video.